Welcome to the Veteran Instruction of Ruse. We're going to explain in-depth details about the game. First of all, I'm going to explain more details about the ruses, and I'm going to ask a specialist, Alexis, Creative Director at Judgment System, to give me more in-depth details about the ruses. So Alexis, what is your favorite ruse in the game?
I won't say I have a favorite ruses. I would more say that I have favorite combos. For example, if I want to attack the enemy and do a great charge, a powerful charge, I will use the Blitz with the Fanatism, meaning that all my units will go twice their speed and they will not root, even if they get substantial damage. Another example is I want to put in the mind of my enemy that my base is on the left side of the battlefield. So I will use a fake building on one hand and camouflage my base on the other one. Combining the ruses together mean stronger ruses, stronger stratagems.
And I guess we didn't find yet all the possible combinations and the players can discover when playing the game. Now, we've covered the factions and the flavor on the whole. Now I'm going to ask Alexis, what are the specific details you can take advantage of when playing a faction?
One of the great things that you can do with the factions is to try to combine different units. For example, if you play the Germans, one great combo is to have battle tank on the front line, followed by assault tank that will be able to destroy all the infantry units and to be able to resist to artillery and infantry units and stuff like this. Also, when you face a German player, you will have to deal with the 88 guns, which are deadly for your tanks and have this huge range of fire. So you will need, if you want to make an offensive with tanks, have also some artillery units in order to destroy those units that doesn't have any armor on them. But also, in each factions, what you will find is that you have a different way of unit that you can produce in the different categories. For example, in the French faction, you will be able to produce some tanks in the barracks, while it will not be the case, for example, for the US will only have infantry units. So, masterizing the factions is knowing exactly what are the assets that you have, but also what are the flows that the nation has.
So from the start, you have different strategies depending on the faction. Some are more powerful in one field in the start, some others
exactly
afterwards. Okay. I suppose you have played multiple matches, even in teams possibly. But the game also incorporates lots of options to change your multiplayer experience. So Alexis, can you explain what are these options and how you can make a different experience?
You have a lot of options, but the most important options you have is by selecting the time of the battle. So you can play a match in 1939 or a match in 1939 to 1942, and the classical match where you have units from 1939 to 1945. Each of this time period will allow you or prevent you from making research for new units. For example, when you will play in 1939, you will have no research available, which means you will have very short amount of unit to play with.
So basically, you can have a completely different experience while trying a faction in 1939 as opposed to the full time period.
Exactly, and that is why it's interesting to give those three different time period. The second point is you can select the length of the game. Normally, a one versus one game is about 25 minutes. You can select exactly the time length you want, or go up to no time limit at all, which is the annihilation mode, meaning that in this mode, the only way to end the battle will be by the full annihilation of one of the opponents. And I will say the final customization that you can do is by selecting the teams. And you are very free to select the team you want, and you can go, if you want, to no team at all, meaning it's going to be a free-for-all game. I think this is a great mode, especially in Ruse, because with the intelligence system we have in the game, with all the information of all the players, the free-for-all mode gets all its flavor in Ruse.
Thank you, Alexi. And finally, the request from hardcore players on how to use keyboard shortcuts, how to maximize the control in the game. So in the game manual, you will find all the details of these shortcuts, such as, for instance, stopping units which you give an order to, chaining orders, creating and recalling groups. Thank you for your attention, and I hope you have a lot of fun playing the beta.